And now we're gonna see the candlelight processional. I almost said professional. The candlelight professional. See the candlelight processional. One more time. And now we're gonna go see the candlelight processional, which is gonna be very cool. Okay, upon returning to EPCOT, the first thing we did was Living with the Land. And I was really excited to go on this because Annette had not been on the ride before, and I had secretly made reservations to go on the Behind the Scenes tour. And she was gonna love it because she's just into all these things about different species of plants and how you grow them and hydroponics and everything. So it's gonna be great.
While doing walking here, just reminding you to keep your hands and arms, feet and legs inside the boat there.
Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, I know you do. Elsa's made a magic winter show. It's summer snow. We're spending here and you. Oh, we're going up to Elsa's ice palace. You and you.
How about us? Does that include us?
All of you.
Nice.
See you there.
China. So beautiful. And I'd love to show you our footage of it, but unfortunately because of a problem with the memory card, we don't have it. But we did have a nice time walking around the pavilion. And just to prove we were there, here's me making a vlog update from the pavilion. It was full of wit and wisdom. What a shame it was lost.
Wow. All right, so we just went on Living with the Land and Frozen in China, the China Pavilion. So what did you think of Living with the Land?
I loved it.
I knew she'd love that.
I had no idea what to expect, and it was so fun to see so many plants I've never heard of and trees, and to see things that I've never seen but I knew about, like coffee. Like, oh my gosh, there's a coffee bean plant. It was just so fun. I wanted to see everything all at once. It was pretty exciting. I hope we get to go in again because I want to see more. Because like
we got another day here.
Looking here, but then you're missing there because it's on two sides. It's a little boat ride through it. And that was one of my favorites.
Yeah, and I love anything with a boat. Just put me on a boat, I'm happy. So, and then we went on Frozen, which is always a lot of fun.
But we went to the shops, and I really liked the shops.
Oh, before we went to Norway shops, yeah, and you got some chocolate.
Chocolate. So it's really fun to talk to the employees because they are from other countries, and they're just here working.
From the country they work
in. Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, it's fun to talk to them. It's something our kids got us into. Talking to them and finding out what their favorite items are in the store and how authentic it is. So we got a chocolate bar from Macy, and I think she's going to love it. I might have a little bit too.
No. None for us. None for you. Okay, and then we went on Frozen, and just a lot of fun, right?
Yeah, it was fun, especially the surprise. Can I talk about it?
Yeah.
Phew, it goes backwards. He's like, what's going on?
And for me, we're on a boat, so I'm always happy on a boat. And then we walked around the China Pavilion and had a great time there. Saw the acrobats.
We went through the shops there.
Went through the little shops and
almost
we saw.
Got a couple things.
Yeah. We saw something pretty funny. We were looking at these little tea sets and this man came up with his daughter. How old was she? Maybe.
Pretty young.
Young. And she just quickly grabbed like a little spoon out of the tea set and put it right in her mouth.
It's like a baby spoon. It's not his perfect size.
He grabbed it out real quick and just put it right back. So we were just laughing so much after they left, thinking somebody's going to buy that tea set at some point in time.
We got to hold that lotus light flower thing.
Yeah.
That was cool.
It'll put,
I like that. I want to see the
Here's
photo.
The picture right here. And then, the photo was nice, but I thought like they would have you hold it, and I've seen other photos, and like you hold it like up to your face like this, and it,
ooh, it lights.
The glow lights up your face, and no, he just like handed it to us, and before you know it, like the flash went off, and that was our photo. That was it. It's a good photo, but could have been better.
And then the acrobats, that was amazing.
Yeah, the acrobats.
That was fun. Some of them were really talented. That was cool.
Some were. No, they were. And now we're going to see the candlelight processional. I almost said professional. The candlelight professional. The candlelight processional. One more time. And now we're going to go see the candlelight processional, which is going to be very cool.
I think that's going to be a highlight for us.
A highlight. We've already had a bunch of highlights. Here comes another.
Woo!
So now it's time to go see the show. We were excited because we had purchased the dining package, so we were going to get a pretty good seat. We knew you could get in for free, but you didn't get a good seat, and you weren't even guaranteed to get a seat for that showing at all. So we thought the package was worth it. And on the night we went, it was Robbie Benson, the voice of the Beast, as the host, and he was pretty good.
Here in my heart, I live in love.
enjoyed that show. The Candlelight Processional is amazing in person. Right after that, we were able to jump right into American Adventure, and as you can see, there was nobody there. I think there were 6 people for the show. And as we watched it, Epcot was emptying out. It was great.
America, spread your golden wings, sail on freedom's wind.
Well, Mr. Twain, what do you think of our America now?
All that was left to do was a very nice, quiet, and romantic stroll out of an almost empty World Showcase. Really would recommend doing that, just waiting till everyone's gone from Illuminations and the music's going and most of the pavilions are empty, and it's just really nice to walk out that way.